NBC5 First Warning Weather with Chief Meteorologist Tom Messner.
Welcome back, everybody. 16 minutes after 6 o'clock, and it is a busy weather day, or weather evening as the case may be, in northern New York. We've got a severe thunderstorm warning in effect. You see this box right here? This is where this warning is. It goes until 6:30 tonight, but you may notice that around the box, we've got kind of an orange outline to it. And in particular, that's because of what's happening up near Ellenburg. Well, meteorologist Tyler Jankowski is here. Tyler, I know you've been watching the wind profiles, I mean, very carefully here. What's the latest on this?
Yeah, Tom, we had a lot of rotation there in northern Franklin County about 20, 30, 40 minutes ago. That's why the National Weather Service went ahead and we call it a little tag. They basically enhance the wording in the severe thunderstorm warning and say, hey, you know, there might be some spin in these storms, and we're wondering here in the Weather Center if there's any damage in this area. So if you live in northern Franklin County, especially north of Malone through Constable, north of Burke and Chateauguay, that's where this storm kind of went through and went north into Canada. You can see the rotation track there. Probably just straight line wind damage, but you never know in these situations. Have to see when the damage reports come in. Now, we still have an ongoing concern moving through Clinton County. This is just going through Lion Mountain, ultimately into Dannemora. There's one little area here that has a little spin heading towards Beekmantown, and then another one right over 374, kind of near the Storts there in town in Dannemora. So mostly just a straight line wind threat, but as Tom mentioned, we're watching for these little kinks in the line for the potential for something more. But right now we do have to be concerned about the wind, right, Tom?
That's right, Tyler. Hey, thanks a lot. Let me show you where these storms are going. They're cranking along at some 40, 45 miles an hour. And I do want to put a track on here and let you know who is in the line of fire here. Just about 8 minutes out from Peru at this point, 12 from Plattsburgh. So we're getting close to the valley itself. Figure Alberg in about 27 minutes. Obviously, we could be talking about winds over 60 miles an hour, maybe quarter-size hail as well. We've got another severe thunderstorm warning in effect down to the south. Kind of hard to see where we are. Elizabethtown, this is Lewis, Lake Champlain under a lot of, what's indicating where the rain is and things like that, up toward Charlotte and Shelburne. That's the direction it's going in. And again, could be looking at gusts to some 60 miles an hour. It's just 8 minutes out from Charlotte, Shelburne 17 minutes, South Burlington 33, assuming it stays together. We've got a severe thunderstorm watch in effect. It goes until 11 o'clock tonight for the highlighted areas here. It's really everybody, with the exception of those in New Hampshire at this point. Temperatures, well, it certainly has cooled down where we've seen some rain in northern New York. Still 70s and 80s as you come a little bit farther to the east. But as we kind of track this along, show you what to expect, 7 o'clock tonight, right over the Champlain Valley, it will continue to be very busy with very strong thunderstorms. Everything cranks off to the east by 9:30. We're still looking maybe at showers in the Champlain Valley, but I think the strongest thunderstorms from the Northeast Kingdom down through the Connecticut Valley and then down toward places like Brattleboro, also into Bennington. Then finally, all this leaves with the passing of that cold front. It is going to be cooler as we get into the day tomorrow. A few showers, maybe a rumble of thunder out there, but I wouldn't be surprised to find even a little bit of sunshine by later in the day. It's alert weather out there tonight. We're expecting damaging wind. We've had three reports of damaging wind events already in St. Lawrence County. Trees knocked down. Winds 60 to maybe 75 miles an hour. A lot of lightning out there. So tonight, obviously, the showers and thunderstorms. The main concern as everything does shift on off to the east. For tomorrow, some scattered showers. Could be a thunderstorm in there. It's going to feel completely different. Temperatures upper 60s and also getting into the 70s. So after tomorrow's 72, few scattered showers, we're on a roll. Gets a little bit warmer in the 70s on Thursday, Friday, Saturday. All those days look good. Scattered showers coming back on Sunday, but next Monday and Tuesday, they look good.